everyone, I'm Shauna and welcome to my channel. Today's video is the first Project Pan update of the year and I'm really excited about it because I made some good progress on basically everything. Let's just get into the update and talking about the products. All of the products, their names and their color variants, if I have them, will be listed in the description box below. And as usual, there will be pictures on the screen of progress photos. First up is the Hello Fab Pores Be Gone Matte Primer. This is where I was last month, and this is where I am now. That's quite a big dip. Not the biggest that we've seen on here, but it is really, I think it's really big. And I think, or I guess I'm more hoping that I can finish this next month. This product has been in my project pan for a long time. It's been in a project pan since 2020, around the springtime. I think March or April is when I brought it in. I'm just really excited to finish this. Like, I want this out and I will be happy to see it go because this is just a mediocre product and it's 1.7 fluid ounces, so almost double the size of a regular foundation. I'm just ready for this guy to leave. And I use that product 8 times. Next up is the e.l.f. BB Cream in Fair. I was there last month and I am here now. I did only use this about 2 times. And I think what's happening now is that I wasn't totally able to get all the air out and more of it is coming out. I did only use this 2 times, so that kind of seems like a really big jump for 2 times. I'm hoping in February, because of some parameters I set up in my self-love and confidence project, that I'll be able to get a bigger dip in this one. The second foundation in this project is the HD, or the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. We have that little, it's just a little dip there. I used this product 8 times, and I guess I thought that the dip would be a little bit bigger. The progress here seems much slower than the other foundations that I've used. Maybe I'm just using less product than I have with others in the past. I do find that this has really good coverage and I like the way that it looks. So either, I mean, even though it's slower, I don't mind this being in the project for most of the year because I really like it. I also just want to note that in my intro video when I was introducing these products, I said I put this product in here because I'm not supporting Catrice. And one of the reasons I said for that was because of the range for this. And many of you let me know in the comments, and I did pin a comment, but I feel like it's also good to say that or say these things verbally in the video series that this belongs to. And many of you guys let me know that Catrice updated their shade range from 4 to 20. And they did that a few months ago, up to a year ago, I think. I'm glad that they did that. And information I put out in that video was not correct. I really appreciated being told that I made a mistake. But my opinion on Catrice still stands. They're a watch and wait kind of brand. Because even though they updated their shade range, they did it. It took them forever to do that, and their most recent release had a poor shade range, and their handling of the criticism, which I felt like was really valid, was really poor, and they were not listening to their customers or people who were commenting in general, and they were not willing to learn or admit that the shade range wasn't good, and they don't seem to want to make any improvement. It feels like the kinds of decisions that were made that allowed 4 shades of this to be released are the same ones that are guiding the brand today. And I don't really want to support that. And it's not like they've really made much attempts to be more inclusive and have a more diverse shade range. So I'm still not supporting the brand. They're still a watch and wait kind of brand, but I did want to bring that up here. So the next product is the e.l.f. Concealer. This is the only product that I can't actually show you the progress. And there's only one in here this time, one in this project of that kind of, hold on. There's only one product in this project that I can't visually show you updates on. This is pretty close to being done. I think I can finish this in a month, and I would really love to do that so I can bring in another face concealer. At most, I think this would take 2 months. I really like this for face, and I would see myself repurchasing this. Next up is the Hourglass Veil Translucent Setting Powder. We have a little change there. I think the close-ups will show you a little bit better. It is slight, and I have panned this style of product before in the past, last year, and I was a little surprised to see such a big change so early on. Usually the use on these kinds of products goes really slow, so that change, even though it is small, is larger than I expected, and I have been using this really regularly. So I don't think I gave the numbers for a couple of those other products. I used the Catrice foundation 8 times, the Camo concealer 9 times, and this translucent powder 9 times as well. The last powder product to talk about today is the ColourPop bronzer. I think that's a pretty big change. It seems like a big change from last month. I really think this product is doable to finish in the next month. I think that's possible. I really want to get this out and reduce the number of ColourPop products I have in my collection. The next product is the ColourPop Cream Gel Liner in Honey Dude. I'm not going to open it for now, and you'll see it opened in the progress picture, but that's only because I broke it and I can't open it without it kind of falling, and it's a mess. But on the card here, I wonder if you can see, you can see a visible dip, and you'll be able to see that better in the close-up shot. That is much, I've never panned an eyeliner before, but I do guess it's similar to panning a lip liner. I use this product every single time I do my makeup, so it's the most used product in my collection. And so I didn't know how fast this kind of product would go, and just in general, but also how far I could go in a month of regular use. And so at this rate, it looks like this is going to be like 6 months in the project. And I'm not excited about that. I don't like this product, and I don't like it, but it's usable. And there might come a time where I might just chuck the broken piece out and just get my beloved Marc Jacobs eyeliner. But I like to use when I can if a product is usable. So it's gonna live to see another day, at least for now. Now let's talk about the two lip products. I have the Bite lipstick in Cashew, or it's the multi-stick in Cashew, it's the mini. Really, really lovely color. And you can see here that there's a decent dip. I'm really proud of that. Lipsticks go slow. The only time I really wear lipsticks now is when I'm filming videos or when I'm on a Zoom call or teaching, those kinds of things. I have to remember to use it because I do have other products in here in different projects and shop my stash. I really want to try and rotate them as best as I can. But even then, even if this was the only lip product I use, they still go slow. And while that's a small amount of progress, I'm very pleased with it. I want to talk about the lip liner before the Glossier Gloss, because the Glossier Gloss has the best progress of the whole video. The Ofra lip liner. I think this is the biggest change I've seen at all since putting it into a project, period. Look at that change. That's a significant dip from there to there. I do like a lip liner, but it takes me a while to use them up. So I'm very, very pleased with that change. Lipsticks and lip liners are those like slow and steady products. And just like the Bite, it's a small update. It's a small change, but I'm so proud of it. I'm so proud of how much I used. And I really come to love this color. So I'm looking out for it now. We're at the beginning of 2020, I had to remember to use it. Whereas now I'm like, where is it? I love it. I want to use it. And I do like layering it with the Glossier gloss and just about everything because it's really great match to my lip color. So the final product before talking about the Bonus Hourglass palette is the Glossier lip gloss. Look at that dip. That is huge. With the rate that I use this, it seems really possible to finish this for next month. And that might be ambitious, but I'm going to set that as a goal and I'm going to strive for it. And I'm really hoping I achieve it because I don't like this product as much as I initially thought. I have a video ranking my lip glosses in my collection and their formulas. And I put this kind of high, like maybe 4 out of 10, number 4 out of 10 gloss formulas. And after having a much more experience using this and using it really regularly, I've changed my mind. And it's now my opinion is that it's too thick and gloopy for my preference. This product isn't moisturizing. It kind of feels like a thick lacquer on your lips, like a seal almost. So like seals don't provide moisture. They just seal things in. It's kind of what it feels like. And so it is thick and gloopy, and that's not really all that pleasant to put on for the first time. It doesn't have like a good application experience, or at least not as pleasant as other products that I've used, or not used, other lip glosses that I have in love. So I'm kind of excited to finish this guy and roll in another lip gloss that I like just a little bit better. I don't have a count for this because I used it so much that I lost count really, really quickly. But as for the other lip glosses, I used the lip liner 7 times and the Bite lipstick 5 times. Now the Hourglass palette, I used this 8 times. Here it is. And I have noticed some dips in this product and this one. They're slight. This powder here has the largest one, and they are coming along. I've used every color in here except for the bronzer because I've been focusing on the ColourPop bronzer. In the intro video, I asked for your recommendations on how to use this product, and a lot of you answered that question. And my favorite way to use, there's lots of different kind of products in here to use them for different reasons, but the one I like the most is this guy at the corner here. This is the strobing powder. Many of you recommended to use this as a highlight, and I have used it that way, and that's the way I like it best. I am wearing it as a highlight today. I feel like it's more on the subtle side, which I do really like. And that's really perfect for more natural makeup days, or I like it best in that kind of setting. As for these powders here, I got recommendations to use it as a setting powder for light coverage foundations, or like the dusting of powder once you're done your whole makeup look and like you're ready to go. Do that to kind of blend things together and like smooth things out. Those were the 3 products I wasn't sure about. I really like the highlighter, and the colors unique to my collection. The finishing powders, they're okay. I don't really have a use for them. I don't really find a finishing powder all that useful, and I don't really feel like I notice a difference when I use them. I did get recommendations to use this one as an under eye setting powder. I think it's okay like that. I haven't tried it with all the concealers that I own, and so there's more testing to do with that particular powder in that way. As for the blushes, they are not really shimmery, but they're like shiny, like iridescent. And because they have that shine to them, I don't really know exactly what the right word is. Shine doesn't feel right, but they're more of like a glowier blush. And that kind of formula I'm not a huge fan of, particularly with powders, because I feel like it doesn't look that great on my cheeks. It makes my acne scars stand out more, and also my pores. So I'm not a huge fan of that. And the colors are more on that pink side, and I'm kind of moving away from that color family. So having two blushes in that color and in that formula just don't do it for me. So would I recommend this palette? I mean, if I was supporting Hourglass, no. I think that I'm moving away from many of these colors. The highlight, I mean, this overall feels like a pink palette. The this guy here, is the highlighter is more on the pinky side. The blushes are more on the pinky side. I'm not loving this palette. The finishing powders are, I think, the product I hear the most about from Hourglass, the thing people swear by. And people talk about how it blurs their lines and pores and those kinds of things. I don't notice that. So to wrap up this video, what I hope to use next month, the Glossier Gloss, the bronzer, and the concealer. Those are the goals. I hope I achieve them. If I finish one of those, I'll be happy. Three of those, even more ecstatic. But I think this first update, this first month of use, really laid the groundwork to kickstart these products. So that's going to complete this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like project panning content, conscious consumer content, I would love to have you here. We do all kinds of that on this channel, as well as my absolute pride and joy, the self-love and confidence project. I would love to have you here. So I think I said thank you so much for watching, because thank you. And I'll see you around here soon. Bye.